Thank you, everyone. On behalf of Steven, Liv, myself, I just want to take a moment and thank everyone for being here. I was trying to figure out everywhere that was represented here, and I quickly lost track. I think we have pretty much the entire country represented here. So kudos to everyone that could make it. I especially want to thank each and every one of you up here with me, hoping to celebrate this day. We know how special this is, and it is truly an honor for all of us to be celebrating this with both Steven and Liv as well. Now, you all have no doubt beholden this beautiful huppah that we are having this ceremony under. Now, the huppah, little bit about it for those of you that may not know, is the wedding canopy. They can vary pretty drastically between ceremonies. This one is, you know, pretty dope, so... Take a moment, you know, just accept it. It's really quite stunning. Now, a few things about the huppah that you may not know. You'll notice it's very wide and open, and that is purposeful. It is meant to be a symbolism of the openness and welcomeness that Steven and Liv wish to have in their marriage. And that also means that they legally have to accept anyone in their home at any time and can't say no. So it's good for everyone to know that. Now, the beams you'll notice right here, they may look like metal and flour, but that is actually not the case. The beams are those of the people up here. They're all of you, and there are even some people that were not able to make it here today. These are your support beams that have been for your past life. They are here with you right now, and they will be with you guys going forward. Again, want to thank everyone up here for being here, and you may now sit. Skedaddle. All right, now one other thing, we do not have it up here, but it will be on display afterwards, is the ketubah. Now, some of you may also not know what that is, and real quick, that is, stop looking at me, look at her, right? So, if you're wondering what it is, I will give you a quick brief description. So the ketubah was actually signed by both Steven and Liv in the back room while you guys were all sitting out here, because we were a few minutes late, sorry about that. And it is a commitment between the two of them for their love and commitment to each other. Miguel and Alex also signed, including myself. And so if you are able to take a look at it tonight, please do so, but again, it will be on display further in their home forevermore. So when you show up unannounced and they can't turn you away, you can really soak it in then. All right? Perfect. Steven and Liv, let's take a little stroll down memory lane. So as I was trying to brainstorm what to say today, I felt like I needed to reach out to both of them and get a little more information about the relationship. I obviously kind of knew the gist of it, but you know, I needed some of the details so that it could really beef up my presentation here. So I was like, all right, let me start with a really simple, easy question. Hey, when did you guys meet on Hinge? Wait, I'm gonna go to my phone for this, one sec. Okay, so I said, hey, do you guys know when you first matched on Hinge? Steven immediately responds, sometime August 2018. A few minutes later, Olivia responds, says, actually, it was June 3rd, 2018. So we matched sometime in May. Steven then responds, oh, with six H's, right. Next text from Steven, too many concussions, LOL. Now, while Steven may have been mistaken in their time when they met, what was unmistakable was how that day changed him. For those of you that don't know, Olivia Lee Van Gundy is named after two great actresses, Olivia de Havilland and Vivian Leigh, both of whom starred in Gone with the Wind. And I cannot think of a more appropriate inspiration for her name, because after they met, Steven was truly swept away by our young Olivia. I think it's probably a little cliche to say that you guys both make each other better, but if you guys knew Steven before this, you knew that he had a lot of room for improvement. But what myself and everyone else also noticed that same thing was after that day, we saw a young man that had something had changed, and he had committed to becoming a better person since that day, and I'm glad to say that he has stuck with that mantra. And that is all Olivia's doing. Now, I've been to New York a few times to visit these wonderful folks, and they've been gracious enough to host me even before the ketubah and all this stuff, so that's encouraging. And while I was there, unfortunately, one of their guinea pigs had just undergone a heat stroke and was not able to walk. Now, if it were me, I'm not going to share what I would have done in that situation, but needless to say, these two did everything under the sun they could to keep her and make her life as wonderful as possible for the rest of her time, which included ordering a specially designed wheelchair that would lock up behind her legs so they could lead her around the house, and they would leave the AC on so that she would not get too hot. And it was at that moment, watching Olivia and Steven lead Stella around the room, that I had that realization that if they treated each other half as well as they treated their animals, this is going to be one really awesome marriage. Liv, who would have thought that that day, June 3rd, 2018, that you have in your calendar as Drinks with Steve from Hinge would turn into something that you now, as you've stated, have as an annual reminder that brings a smile to your face every day, or at least once a year. And here we are, here you are, here Steven is, and here all of us are celebrating that beautiful day. Okay, next up, the bride and groom have requested some audience participation. Okay, so I hope you guys are ready for this. It's going to be kind of a call and response of sorts. So what's going to happen, I'm going to ask the audience a question, a vow, and you guys are going to respond when I point to you with a "we do." Okay? We do. Yeah, we'll do a quick practice. Okay? So I'm going to say something, you know, like, is this the best, or do you think this is the best officiated wedding you've ever seen?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, we're going to do that. Okay? All right, to the crowd. Do you commit to being part of the community that Olivia and Steven will build together?
We do.
Do you commit to sharing your love, support, and positivity with Olivia and Steven?
We do.
Do you commit to challenging Olivia and Steven to grow as individuals while deepening their partnership?
We do.
All right, this one you guys better take seriously. Do you commit to celebrating Olivia and Steven tonight on the dance floor?
Yeah.
We're going to hold you to that. All right. And now, Steven and Olivia would like to share their vows that they've both wrote for each other. Sorry, they're a little sweaty, but... All right, here you go, Liv.
Steve, I knew from pretty early on that we were supposed to be together. I remember knowing after a few months of dating that I had found my person. I grew to love the crosstown bus just because it meant I was on my way to see you. Your tenacity for everything you do drew me in. First, I saw it with cooking, career, and exercise, but then I learned how you apply it to relationships. You work so hard to be an amazing friend, brother, and son. I feel tempted to pull this room to ask how many people have had or will have you in their wedding. I'm so thankful that you've chosen to give your heart to me and to be my husband. I see how much you prioritize the life that we're building together, and I'm thrilled to make these vows to be your wife. Steve, I vow to be honest and faithful to you always. I promise to cherish, trust, and respect you, to support you while we celebrate the highest of highs and persevere through the lowest of lows. I vow that even when times are hard, we'll work as a team. I promise to help you be the best version of yourself and to always strive to be my best self for you. We'll nurture one another emotionally, spiritually, and intellectually, and embracing our respective qualities, strengths, and heritages. Together, we will build a home full of romance, respect, laughter, and joy. Steven Mendoza, I love you with my entire heart, and I'll continue to for the rest of my life.
Tough act to follow. Olivia? You have made me the happiest man in the world by being here today, ready to share your life with me. On this day, I make a vow to love you through the best and worst of times. I promise to cherish you and everything that you are and will become throughout our union. I will support you with your dreams and ambitions and will push you constantly so that you may always be the best version of yourself, and I will push myself to be the best version of myself for you. I promise to be faithful, loyal, and to always trust and care for you. I promise to be your best friend, your loving partner, and a romantic husband. I will always put effort into keeping a smile on your face. I also promise to try and be more tolerant with the crap corner. And we'll try to be less rowdy and loud during football season. I pledge to make food less spicy. And I promise to allow the cat on the bed when I'm away on trips. Olivia, I love you so much. And I know this love will only grow as our union grows and progresses. So again, thank you for being here today, making me the happiest man in the world.
Okay, you guys ready for the I do's? All right. Steven, do you take Olivia to be your wife? To live together in matrimony, to love her, to honor her, to comfort her, and to keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Olivia, do you take Stephen to be your husband, to live together in matrimony, to love him, to honor him, to comfort him, and to keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I absolutely do.
All right, now it's time for the ring exchanges. Mikey? I got a handful here. All right. All right, Olivia, you go first, since you're better at this. All right, repeat after me. I, Olivia Lee Van Gundy. Offer you this ring. To wear as a symbol of our unbreakable bond. It's a reminder of my eternal faith. And unwavering dedication. I will cherish you forevermore. All right. Yep, do it. All right, Stephen, repeat after me. I, Stephen Mendoza. Offer you this ring. To wear as a symbol of our unbreakable bond. It is a reminder of our eternal faith. And unwavering dedication. I will cherish you forevermore.
I will cherish you forevermore.
All right, hard part is over. Okay, so the last thing we're going to do is the traditional breaking of the glass. For that, I would like to ask the wedding parties to come back up and join us. Perfect. You guys got up here a lot faster than you left. Great. So before we get to this final stage, I just want to share a little more about this tradition. You guys may not have thought you were going to get a quick TED talk on all of the traditional Jewish wedding traditions, but here we are. There will be a quiz after. So there are a lot of interpretations or originations of where this came from. We don't have time to go through all of them, but the one that really resonates with Stephen and Liv, which as I read up more on, it's really kind of a nice thought, is that despite all this happiness and gratitude that's here, we still live in a broken world. And rather than having that reminder dampen today, I'm going to ask everyone to take that as an opportunity to share the love, to share the gratitude that is felt today, and let it spill over into the rest of the world as you guys go back from all the corners of the country that you guys came after this. Now, for those of you that are a little more familiar with Jewish tradition, you may notice that there are two glasses here. Usually it's only one, usually it's just the man, but in keeping with their commitment to melding both tradition and progression, they have chosen to do it together. Now, once they break it, they will be married, all right? So that's a big deal. So when you hear the glass, everyone needs to yell Mazel Tov as loud as they can. Okay, we can't do a test run on this for obvious reasons. So you guys better get it right the first time, okay? All right, you guys ready?
Yes.
You want to count down?
3, 2, 1.
Okay, everyone, please rise as they exit. And it is my distinct pleasure to announce for the very first time the Vandozas.
Leave me.